Welcome back to the Badger Open. First game in the second semifinal here. The first semifinal was a good technical match. 4-3. Newcomer Li Pu moves into the final of the Badger Open. Tong Zhang with a heavy spin ball off the side under serve. Very difficult to make that re-loop. Wow. That's the kind of mistake you don't see at this level. It could cost them the game. Could have been 5-6, but 4-7. A little bit of surprise there. I thought Jishan would control this match, but it's still really early. Tong in the yellow has a huge forehand. Not much backhand. Jishan has a huge forehand, but doesn't use it that much. Doesn't run around a lot and stays solid with 40% backhand and 60% power forehand. A little bit just off the edge. Hesitation from Jishan cost him the point. No spin serve. A big wind up loop off the top of the net and long. It's a really long swing he has on the forehand, which gives super power, but it can be exploited when they're swinging that big. Nice flip there. Tong with a lot of topspin. Jishan normally would make that re-loop. Ball jumped off his racket long. Second semifinal in the Badger Open. 3,000 for the winner. Oh. That's not going to work. A little side top serve. Tong trying to drop it in softly, but 9-7. The all important first game. Oh, there's Jishan with that trademark backhand block. He loves to take it cross court to the righty's wide forehand. If there's a difference in this match, is that Jishan has the better backhand. There's that monster forehand with that sort of lasso cowboy-like swing. Huge swing. When you play a player like Xu Xin from China, or even, you know, when they take those big swings and they make them, so hard to find the ball, and the arc is different. Xu Xin is a nightmare if you know table tennis, and Tong is a little bit like that too with that massive swing, but he sure does push a lot. Look at that block. If you like table tennis and you like to read, I just wrote an autobiography of my life story. I played in table tennis for 50 years, and it's a couple hundred pages. It's called Revelations of a Table Tennis Champion, and you can get it on Amazon.com. I read a lot of books and of players, Bjorn Borg and Andre Agassi and John McEnroe and Arnold Palmer, and I think my book kind of is the same type of book. Can learn a lot, and it's a pretty good story. If I say so myself, I think people will be very interested once they read it, and I'm very interested to see what they think. Just came out this week. two each. Jishan in the red is playing out of the Triangle Table Tennis Center in North Carolina. And Tong is from Mississippi College. Tong is best known for making that big counter loop against Texas Wesleyan when they were down match point in the finals of the team and stopped the Texas Wesleyan streak at 13 championships in a row. It's been pretty humid in the hall today. There's no air conditioning. Usually it's a little cooler in September, but it's definitely humid. There's that big power loop, and I mean, talk about power. The block went off by like 4 feet. If you play Tong and you minimize those big loops that he gets, he can be beaten. Doesn't have a lot of other parts of his game. It's a forehand or nothing. Like earlier in the quarterfinals, Jishan's slow starter was down 1-0 and 9-0 in the second, almost down 2-0. Pulled that one out. Look at that counter loop by Tong. Beautiful. I thought Jishan had it there with a beautiful powered loop, but right off the bounce, Tong scores to keep himself in this game. That was a big point. Oh, that's a freebie there. You'll take them. You try to win a point any way you can. If you have to scramble or you get a lucky one. A lot of times that can mean the match. Oh, nice little slapper there. Oh, that was ugly. Excellent return by Tong. Dropped it short and heavy. Jishan tried to slide a flip inside out, but the underspin just went flip right in the bottom of the net. Oh, 7-8. Big moment in this match right here. Match ping pong back and forth. It turns so quickly. 8-5 turns to 8-0. And now Jishan looking to be 1-1, no problem. Once again in danger. He could be going down. The number one seed could be going down 2-0. He goes to side top. For sure side top. Tong is unwilling to flip that ball. He probably should flip it. Let's see if he flips this one because he's going to get side top again. Nope, changed it. Oh, why would he change it? That's what he's saying. Why did I change it? You knew he wasn't going to like the other serve. But you got to give Tong credit. Boy, he sure made a great shot there. Recognized the hook topspin. Just picked it right up off the bounce and surprised Jishan. 9-9. Wow. Jishan blowing a big game. Looks like 9-10. Excellent serve there. Heavy under. It was a little high, and I think that's what threw Jishan off. Game point. Game point. Oh. That's a champion there. I mean, he missed that one at 10-8 or whatever, and then came right back and did it again. And absolutely ripped it. That was one heck of a shot. I even say it was one hell of a shot. Here we go. He's going to go side top guaranteed. Yep. No chance for Tong. You should know it's coming, folks. It's coming. Flip the ball. You can't drop that one, Tong. Oh, the big forehand lets him down, and Jishan steals the game. Just picks it right up and steals the game a little bit there. Just like he did in the quarterfinal. One game each. Right now, the 2300 is starting to wind down out there. They have matches starting at 6 o'clock also. Tong Zong in the yellow from Mississippi College. Made that great comeback in that last game, and then a couple errors, and it all went for naught. Jishan Liang in the red. Nice little pickup by Tong. Excellent flip kill. Jishan's going to milk that side topspin serve until Tong flips one of them. Just really can't drop that serve. He's been getting away with it by cutting it pretty good. But the long serve will cost you. It's 2-2. I got the score wrong over there. Nice flip on a heavy underspin. Difficult ball. Roundhouse forehand scores again. It's kind of interesting. I was just thinking, well, how many times Tong scores on anything other than his forehand. Not too often. Not really scores anywhere else. When he gets that forehand in play, it's pretty much 90%. Other than that, he's 90% losing the points on the other stuff. Nice serve. Good rhythm on that serve. Side under heavy. Jishan trying to drop it, but dropped it right in the net. No spin. No spin serve, but it goes long. I'm sure he didn't want that. If you're out there, we also have the Butterfly Team Championships, which will be held November 25 to 27 in Philadelphia. Just go to butterflyteams.com. This year we're going to have groups of 11. Should be playing a lot of matches in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. November 25 and 27, three players to a team. You can have up to five. Nothing more than more fun than playing for a team and playing so many matches on a weekend. You learn a lot, you get to play a lot, you get to hang out with your buddies, you get to win for your team, or unfortunately sometimes lose for your team, but that's sort of the fun of it. But the losing's no fun, but the winning sure is. In my book I say that when you lose it's kind of like a sword going right through you, and when you win it's like a magic carpet ride. Never took a magic carpet ride, but I'll tell you, that's what it feels like. 6-8. These 4 out of 7s take a long time to kind of get to the dramatic points. I kind of like the 3 out of 5s these days more. Not much separation between these two. Three games, pretty much dead even, 7-8. That was a side under serve. He's going to go with the side top. Two serves in a row where he allowed Jishan to be aggressive. And Jishan decided that that's the way he was going. He wasn't going to go push that ball. He's going to loop. And the long serve by Tong is going to cost him there. 9-9. Side under. Tong's got to find a way to get this serve back and make the block, because it's definitely the loop is coming. There it is. Oh, he made the block, but you know that I feel that that's a serious weakness in Tong, just the fact that you know he's going to push this ball. And then he's trying to recover, so technically not that strong in that area, that's for sure. I'd be surprised if he's going to push this one too. He's going with the backhand, that's a lot better. Much better. Just move over there and use your backhand, just like Jishan was doing to you. You certainly can't receive that on the forehand side. 10-10, 1-1. Tong tried to make a short serve, but it fell off the side of the table. Jishan let it go down low and spun it up and took control of the rally. You gotta keep that second bounce on the table. Sometimes it falls off the side. Oh, great turn of serve. A little high, side under. Tong just flicked it with the backhand. Get back to 11-all. Tong can't believe it. He made a beautiful serve and follow loop, and then second ball, just a little late. Great block, though, by Jishan. He pushed it forward, and that's what made Tong's loop a little late. Oh, it's over. Too many pushes leads to defeat. Game four, men's semifinals. Jishan serves off to go down 0-2. Up 2-1, though. He's been walking a tightrope. Quarterfinal, lost the first game, was induced in the second, and same here, and he's induced in the second, induced in the third, but up 2-1. He's won the big points. Nice push, good control. This is the number one seed against the number three seed. Wang Yutian was the number two seed, but he dropped out in the semifinals to Li Pu, a new player from China. Fast serving, oh, wake up Charlie. Fast serve to one side and big loop to the other. Bing bang. When you're receiving serve, you gotta look for that fast serve. You only have a moment to react. Almost less than a moment, like half a moment. There is such a thing. That's a quality reloop. A lot of strength in that. Jishan very strong in the upper body and turns and can overpower that ball. That serve was definitely really illegal, but no one's really looking for that. I would just like to see them warn him a little bit, or at least say, hey, you can't throw the ball directly sideways and then hide it with your shoulder. I don't know why umpires don't call it. It's a mystery to me. It's an absolute mystery. I mean, bottom line is they're both hiding the serve, but that don't make it right. That's not the way a sport's supposed to be played. But to me, I have to say that that's kind of why table tennis is always small, because they can't even get the service rule right. I mean, for an organization to not be able to get the service rule right is an embarrassment. Absolute embarrassment. I agree 100% with Larry Hodges and that you could clean this up and no problem at all if you just enforce the rules. And if the player is going to hide the serve, they're going to pay the price, they'll clean it up in 2 seconds. Every one of these players has clean serves. Every one of them. But if they're not called, they have to serve them because the other guy's serving them. Netball 2155. Sorry if I get off on a rant sometimes, but the service thing bothers me. That definitely bothers me. It's been bothering me for a long time, because when you're lefty and you play a righty, you can't see anything. A block that's really solid on Jishan. You can't loop right into his backhand. Boy, he'll take that cross court all the time. And when you get a power loop, it's good, and you know it's got a lot of energy. You got to take it back to the cross court, the furthest point, so you have margin for error. Jishan does that really well. He gets caught, and he takes that backhand to that far forehand corner, right in that corner. He's got a lot of margin for error, and when it lands, it's literally a winner, too, because it's breaking out. A little quick on that forehand, a little nervous. Sometimes when you serve topspin and the other guy pushes it, the ball's got a lot of funky spin on it. It's turning on its side and it's a little bit gooey. Not easy to make that loop. You got to really lift. Anyway, got another close, dramatic match, folks. Could be going 2-2 here. Probably rightfully so. I mean, Tong won the first and lost close to second, close to third. If he can win this, they're 2-2. And oh, just missed the block. Looked pretty good from here. Tong with that huge forehand. Must be like 6 foot long. He's got like a 2 foot backswing and a 3 foot follow through. And he's pretty quick, though. He gets ready for that next ball in time, which is not easy. That's why his backhand's weak, though. He's gonna. Anybody that overplays their forehand like that, it's impossible for them to have a great backhand. Otherwise, they'd be playing on the China team. You play someone like that with a power forehand, you just gotta minimize it and get them deep in their backhand. But the best way to get there is wide forehand. But it's dangerous because you gotta put quality out there. And Jishan just falls apart. But you got to give Tong credit. He made some great shots there at the end of the game. And a little lack of concentration. And we're two games each here in the semifinal.
Danny Seemiller taking a little break for this one game. So this is Barbara, I'll be covering for this very exciting semifinal match. We're 2-2 with Liang Jishan, last year's finalist, and Zhang Tong from Mississippi College. The two have met once before, with Liang Jishan winning at the U.S. Collegiate National Championships this past April. And both players really just going at it, really, really focused, big, high-risk shots. It's really paying off. Opening point. Nice control. And Jishan just missed that backhand. He's really not a big backhand player. should really be using his forehand all the time. And both players are actually really just big forehand players. You'll see there should be very little backhand to backhand rally. Nice and soft, actually. He goes just a little shorter and slower than Liang Jishan thought. He didn't make that step in to finish that counter loop. Go 2-2, really close fifth game, this best of seven semifinal. Reaching the semifinal guarantees the players $500, but winning will guarantee them at least $1,500. Lucky net off of that backhand. You know, and even though Zhang Tong didn't win that point, it's important to see that he's really pushing and pushing Jishan to not step around. So going really wide into that backhand corner, forcing these backhand loops. It's a good strategy. We'll see if he can convert that into points in the rest of this game. This game is super crucial in this best of seven. The leader in a 3-2 definitely has a big edge going into the sixth game. And when you see these backhand shots going out, it's mostly whoever swings at them misses. And so they're really just trying to force each other to not play the forehand. Dead ball, nice control, nice push, and again, a backhand swing that misses. Nice backhand opening. And Zhang Tong able to get that first one, but not able to sustain that rally, especially if you're going into Jishan's forehand. Nice and slow loops. The rhythm is different. And that's really causing Jishan just a few problems. Although it's a risky shot because if the placement is not good, then Jishan can just step around and really counter loop it with his forehand. He's not afraid to do that. Really technical match. You know, we're not seeing a lot of huge, huge rallies. They really kind of control the play and figure out, you know, what's the best strategy. Oftentimes, you know, we really are excited about the big, big points that last a long time, but the real winners are the ones who can win before you even get there. Again, control into the forehand. Jishan running away with game five, a crucial point here in the semifinal. Let's see if he can get this fifth point, or we're gonna go backhand rally. Nice block. 10-4. There we go. Very quick fifth game. Liang Jishan in it to win it. Second place last year. Definitely doesn't want to finish in that place again. Mississippi College bringing a contingent of four players this year and occupying three of the eight quarterfinal spots, and one of the semifinal spots. Zhang hanging on here. Deciding sixth game coming up.
Well, 11-4. What happened in that game there, Barbara?
Well, it was actually very, very technical, and I think they were going after some backhand rallies, and Jishan just made more of them. They're really forcing that backhand rally. No big, not a lot of back and forth in this game.
Jacek just gave a yellow card to the coach in the corner because they took too long, but he was just smiling. He's the umpire. Ooh, big forehand.
And we're seeing actually already more forehands than before. In that other game, we saw a lot of forceful backhand rallies.
Now, I watched that last serve. That serve was so hidden. I just don't know why they just let them do that. Definitely a back-and-forth match. Tong forehand has done real well, but beautiful power loop by Jishan. So strong in the upper body, and when he gets that topspin ball, he can turn it back, and it takes a lot of force to do that. His ball definitely has force.
Well, that's, I think, a key difference. You know, both of these players are forehand players, but Jishan's forehand just has a lot more force, a lot more power.
Well, and his backhand's definitely a lot better. He's got a much better backhand than Tong.
That's true.
That's a beauty there. Yeah, Tong doesn't even use his backhand hardly ever, except for blocking. That was a big backhand loop there. Jishan generally struggles against the underspin on the backhand, but
that was a great one.
That was a beauty. Nice little drop shot. It was
a little high.
A little bit high, but so short. Jishan thought he could get there, but he didn't move his feet. Just sort of jumped across.
You know, the two have met once before at the Collegiate Nationals, and it wasn't even close for Jishan, so this is a much closer match.
Well, I thought that was a good return of serve, but Tong likes to turn that corner and use the forehand. I don't think he's looped a backhand this whole match.
Yeah, well, he did in that game five.
Did
he? It didn't turn out very well.
No, that's probably why. You know, when you're a heavy forehand player and you go to the backhand, you start missing those. Nice block. That's his trademark block.
Exactly. And you're right. I think that's the biggest difference, that Jishan has a big backhand and he can make those blocks as well.
He makes that block cross court. That's really one of his best shots. And he doesn't block it soft either. He takes it right into the corner and drives it there.
Error.
You can't help but say, oh, on that one, because it was so high. And, you know, again, it's a topspin serve. And when they come over, they look so juicy, but they're kind of loaded with funky spin because of the topspin that you serve turns into underspin inside.
And you got to really pay attention.
Yes, you do. And you have to lift it. You really have to lift it.
There we go.
Nice counter loop.
Yeah. Zhang taking a totally different approach this game than game five. There was a lot of backhand play in game five, and it was just not working out for him.
It's amazing when you watch this match. You watch like 10 points, and it looks like Jishan is clearly the winner. And then the next 10 points, it looks like Tong is kind of better than Jishan. You know, it kind of goes back and forth technically and physically. I mean, this is a big game here. If Tong can win this, he'll have the momentum.
He will, and if Jishan can win, then he's in.
He's in for sure. This is a big game, but and Jishan's been walking a tightrope in the quarters and now in the semis, kind of winning all the close games. I don't think he's lost a close one. No spin.
Ooh.
Yeah, that's too
not
big.
Not quite there.
Yeah, that's the one where he's jumping to the left and then big loop down the line. So a lot of movement and then down the line, pretty tough shot. And change direction of the ball. Three things. Jishan is a pretty experienced player, very calm. That's how you win the close games. You keep your mind on your techniques, make a good choice on your serve, and be ready. Look at that heavy underspin.
Really heavy.
And I think he's going to close him out right here, maybe.
Let's see. He had some momentum. He was down 6-4, I think, three in a row.
Wow. There's that powered loop. Beauty. Beauty. Tong with a beautiful spin loop. Landed a little short.
But Jishan was right there.
When they land a little short, the power swing of Jishan, that was not luck. That was clear. He had that ball. 6-8. We may have our finalists.
Well, this is a big point here. Mm.
First time Jishan decided to sit down and block. It was unusual.
When we talked about against Tong's teammate, he was doing a lot of blocking, but now we see a lot more counter looping. Ooh, 8-8.
Yes, sir. Nice serve.
Two big serves here by Jishan could make the difference.
Definitely the game is in the balance. With a heavy spin.
Big rally here.
Oh, yes, sir. One of the best rallies of the match. Three counter loops apiece. And then Jishan with the strength goes up one.
Another big point coming up. Uh-oh. Oh, wow.
Oh, wow.
Nothing you could do about that one.
Nice flip kill, and then last moment save by Tong. Down the line, off the edge. And that was a great play. You could say a little lucky, but I would say great play.
I mean, Tong was right there. He was standing there.
He recovered. Well, he was a little bit over to the right, and then he dashed to the left corner to pick that up and picked it right up. Had to curve it in.
Here we go. Key part of the match. Again, they're just becoming even more and more key. Two serves by Tong. So we go for it. There we go. First game point.
Nice block there by Tong. He was very patient. He knew that Jishan had moved out of position, so he blocked it right back down the line. Jishan didn't have any room to maneuver, and then an easy forehand. That point right there may have turned the match, because Tong realizes that he can sometimes block that ball if he wins this game.
Here we go, another backhand.
There's the block. Exactly, that's what I'm saying. If he can block a few balls, it'll change the whole momentum of the game, and because he didn't do that at all. And Jishan's not expecting that.
Yeah, and I know Jishan always goes for that banana flip at the tight points.
That one was pretty safe, though. It was too soft.
That's true.
Usually he puts a little mustard on it, but that one there, he just gave it soft, gave Tong an easy block, which then made
everything harder for him.
Yeah, now he's on the backhand, a little bit on the move. We got game seven, folks. This is pretty good. I mean, it doesn't get much better than that. They're both tough competitors. They're playing for $3,000.
And each of them are, you know, only guaranteed 500 right now in the semis, but the second place is 1,500, so it's a big jump to get into
that
jump, final.
Yeah. Can make you sad. Well, let's see the technique. I mean, obviously you always want to get out in a good start, but you don't want to say that because that'll kind of lead you to a bad one. You just want to, you know, think about the techniques and if there's going to be a change, are you going to make it or is he going to make it? And if he makes it, are you going to be looking for it?
What would you do, Danny? You've played a lot of seven-game matches in your life.
I lose them all the time now. You know, generally, you know, every match is different, so you have to figure out, you know, you know, every player is different. You know, should be serving short and looping, should be serving dead ball or topspin or under. So you have to really figure out what you need at the moment.
So who do you think is the underdog right now going into game seven, watching this match?
I'm always wrong, so I don't know if I should make a thing there. I'm kind of rooting for Tong because he's been behind and
coming back at the end.
Mm-hmm. And he seemed a little outgunned in this match.
He did in the beginning, for sure.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that game, that fifth game, 11-4, he didn't have anything for Jishan when they were forcing those backhands. So we will see.
Yeah, what I want to see is I don't really care who wins. I want to just see that they play well and that it's sort of a good rallies, some good rallies and good techniques, and that's what we're going to see. I mean, this is game seven. They're totally warm. I mean, both these players are going to give their absolute best in these next 10 minutes. The first one to 11 is probably going to win $3,000.
That's true.
Here
that's
we go.
That's true.
First point, big one. No spin. Good return. Very good return.
Short.
Pretty conservative start. Tong could have looped that ball. It was high. He could have.
Was it long enough?
It wasn't long enough, but it was high enough. He could have got it.
That block.
Wow.
Oh,
nice.
And they're going to play hard. They're in it.
That loop right into the pocket. It looked like Jishan had made a couple nice blocks, and then Tong fired one right on his left hip. Tied him right up.
It was good. Three or four forehands in a row.
I love to watch the focus, and you can see. Oh,
oh beautiful.
Tong
first
makes
backhand.
Yes, sirree. He saw it coming, though. It was pretty obvious, and that was his only option.
Yeah, no way he could turn.
Yeah, it was a dead ball serve. He dropped it a little high. He knew Jishan was coming in for the flip, and he got back and recovered.
Oh, yeah. Misread. Still
yeah.
Misreading.
Yeah, I think he kind of knew it was topspin. He just cut it too hard, and it sailed. Probably not the best choice, but wasn't a bad choice. See how
nice
that
wide.
One was a little longer, but the other one was like the same, but it was just shorter, but it was still high. You can get those balls. That's a big loop.
And super wide into Jishan's wide backhand.
When he winds up that arm, you really don't know where it's going, but it's almost
That's
always
right.
going cross court, though. It's almost always cross court.
Unless he's around the corner. Oh, wow, a backhand loop. He should really not. I mean, that was a good loop in general. But
that was very nice. Jishan just made a better ball.
Yeah.
He was ready, counter loops it, and it's definitely something he's good at.
3-3 and 3-3. Very, very close in the second
Yeah,
game.
Look at that scoreboard all the way across. Oh, he flipped the serve, but a little soft. Jishan, the magician, he walks the tightrope and usually comes out the winner.
That's true. I haven't seen him lose any close matches.
Mm.
A little bit of an unforced error.
Little bit. It was big. Big bit. No, just a little under pressure now. Tong's definitely feeling it. Jishan's in the driver's seat right now, mentally and on the scoreboard. But will it be enough?
What changes do you think Tong needs to make?
He really can't make any real change. If he could do anything, he just has to serve, I think, the side under into the forehand. It's spinning heavy down the middle.
Yeah, that has worked in the past.
And down the middle, not to the forehand where he can re-loop it or even to the backhand. But down the middle would be the best. Especially at this point. He needs to get a good heavy spin in there and make Jishan miss the re-loop. It would always be interesting to listen to what the coaches say. You know, it'd be nice to get a microphone in there.
It would.
And really listen to what Yichi just said, you know, okay, what are you going to do? And then we might have an idea what serve he's going to give and what he's looking for. We just don't have enough microphones. We gotta wire them up. We should wire up one of the coaches sometime. You know? That would be cool.
That would be cool.
I'm sure Coach wouldn't mind.
Here you go. This may change the momentum.
Goes with the underspin and the heavy spin loop. That's what I was looking for. But now Jishan knows it's coming. But don't change it.
He won't do anything different anyway.
He might. He
you
might.
Think so?
Oh, he might. That's part of the game. Cat and mouse.
That.
It was a little different, but not much. A little long. I'm going to pay for that with a backhand loop.
Maybe a banana flip. He is not spinning enough.
Very smart.
That was smart.
Yep.
Let's just go for something totally different.
Well, yeah, and Jishan kind of was moving for the banana, and all of a sudden he had a fast topspin to his white forehand. That was a big technical chance, and it worked like a charm. Tong is so focused at the announcement on the loudspeaker, he wanted to wait.
That's backhand, yeah.
Well, you know, when he serves no spin and then Jishan pushes and then he loops, Jishan's not going to miss that block. There's not enough rotation on it. He should be serving the underspin and then spin it up.
6-4, still a tight game.
Pretty good return, but a bad block.
That's not a good block.
And Jishan's always tough in the big points. He came all the way from North Carolina. He didn't want to fly all the way to Milwaukee and lose.
Same with the Mississippi College team, though. Oh, wow, two very quick points out.
That serve is super heavy. And I might say that Tong never saw the contact.
That's true. There's no chance. Off.
There's no chance he saw the contact.
Here you go, 4-8.
Side top.
Missed, right?
Yeah. It's all over, folks. Jishan's experience and backhand play. And, you know, they were dead even at 3, right? And all of a sudden, 6-1, that's, you know, that's sort of sport, boy. It's just kind of great when it goes your way. Tong's a lot younger, a little bit more inexperienced. Sure, played pretty well this match to take it to 7, but it's not over yet.
Oh,
wow. Wow. It sure looked like it was going to be 10-4.
It really did.
But off the bounce down the line, 9-5, he still has some life.
It's an uphill battle, but you never know.
When you get to 6-9, 7-9, they get nervous.
Oh. That was coming.
Yeah, it was the no-spin serve. No-spin serve, you can't just float it, but easy from this chair. Should have spun that one. It was long.
I should have looped it.
Yeah, it was long.
Can't stay alive here.
That was long, too. Oh. Jishan wanted to go out with a bang. A flip kill flying through the air. We've seen some big upsets today, and mine was one of them. And Wojciech Wolski in the 2400 final was up 10-6 in the fifth and lost.
Let's see what happens here, though.
Oh, yeah.
Right?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Stay tuned, folks. Stay
Not
tuned.
Not over yet.
Absolutely. Come on, one at a time, and let's see some drama. I would like to see him take a big risk here and try to get a quick one. I don't think he can work his way for 3 points.
Might be. It's really an uphill battle. Let's see.
No spin. Oh, a little heavy.
Heavier than timeout. Good choice from Jishan.
That was pretty good. Timeout.
Yeah. Good. That's the right time.
Every match goes 7. Every match goes close.
That's how you know there was really no leader coming into this tournament.
Right. And you know, the bad thing about sports, which we have to accept, is that, you know, sometimes there shouldn't be a loser.
That's right.
But there is.
There always is.
Yeah. You know?
Both of these guys are playing fantastic.
Yeah, whoever wins is going to be really happy, and loser will come over and get the old nice try. Nice try. I don't like
that. Isn't
that
the worst?
Nice try is the worst.
Silence is perhaps better.
Yeah. Sometimes at the end of this last game, I'm thinking, if you lose this, you're going to say nice try, and if you win it, it's going to be pretty good.
Jishan has two serves now. It's going to be, let's see if Tong can handle that, because he missed that wide forehand long one.
Jishan can go with the heavy one, probably. The heavy cut that he hides. That one's definitely one of the options. And the second one will definitely be the side top. It's going to be one or the other. One's going to be a 10-8, and the other one's going to be a 10-9. I think the first one will probably be the heavy one.
You think the heavy one?
I think so.
A little safer?
Nope, he's going to top, I think. Yep, top spin. I thought that was wrong. You don't want to go top spin and let Tong come after him. Now, this one for sure is going to be the heavy one. For sure.
What do you think Tong should do with that heavy one? It's hard to say.
He needs to cut it deep and make the block. It's his only option, I think. Here comes the heavy one. There it is. That's not going to work. Oh, he makes the block.
Oh, oh my gosh.
He made the block. He made the block. But then the backhand was a little inside out and long, and what a match, folks.
Wow.
What a match. 11-9.